My project investigated the use of reinforcement learning in a multi-agent context where agents need to cooperate or compete with each other. Multi-agent reinforcement learning for autonomous vehicles is of particular interest to me. However, multi-agent reinforcement learning can be applied in many other domains as well. For this project, my approach has been to clone and modify two repositories from GitHub. One of my objectives was to demonstrate that multiple agents could reach respective goals whilst avoiding collisions by negotiating with each other. A key finding is that the behavior of agents can be reduced down to one tunable parameter, which dictates their level of defensiveness or aggressiveness. This has significant implications for the design of autonomous vehicles, whereby a balance between passiveness and assertiveness must be found. My second objective was to investigate the interaction between human-controlled agents with AI-trained agents. A key finding is that in adversarial games, agents whose adversary is a policy-trained agent display qualitatively similar behavior to that of agents whose adversary is human-controlled. This suggests that if an autonomous vehicle were to encounter an unpredictable human driver on the road, it should behave with similar behavior to when it faced its AI counterparts in training simulations. My first approach was to use Q-tables, that is, Q-learning, where an agent's policy is stored in a large table of Q-values. My aim was to test whether multiple agents could interact successfully by using Q-tables. The reason I chose to use Q-tables is because using Q-tables is the simplest form of reinforcement learning. For example, OpenAI's Jim has demonstrated how using Q-tables can solve their very simple frozen lake game, as demonstrated on the screen. The algorithm that makes this type of learning work can be reduced down to one simple equation, the Bellman equation. The Bellman equation states that the expected long-term reward for a given action is equal to the immediate reward from the current action combined with the expected reward from the best future action taken at the following state. First, I cloned a repository by Siraj Raval, which used Q-tables in a single agent environment. I modified the code in order to add multiple agents. Then, I got them to encounter challenging tasks where they would need to figure out how to negotiate with each other in order to reach their goals whilst avoiding collisions. In this example, both blue and orange agents are rewarded by landing on the green cell. However, they are also punished by colliding into each other. We can witness a sort of oscillatory behavior as agents attempt to negotiate with each other as to who should give way to who. Eventually, they are able to overcome this stalemate and avoid colliding on a consistent basis. Take a look at how quickly the average number of collisions per episode drops off as agents learn to avoid one another. What else is interesting is how the agents are able to increase their average reward over time. After a volatile start, their rewards tend to converge to a steady state in the long run. To scale this up, I created a plus-shaped environment and introduced two more agents. In this new complex world, agents were assigned anywhere between 1 to 4 goals at random, as indicated by the up, down, left, and right arrows. These goals were hidden from all other agents, so everyone had to hazard a guess as to where to move next. Amazingly, agents were able to conquer this terrain with Q-tables alone. However, Q-tables had limited benefits. Introducing a fifth agent would cause loading times to increase exponentially. This is because Q-tables are suitable for environments with a relatively small number of possible states. This is why I decided that my next step would involve implementing neural networks. Deep Q networks are neural networks used to store an agent's policy in reinforcement learning. My second approach was to implement deep Q networks in a multi-agent setting. Luckily, OpenAI has open-sourced an algorithm that does just that. The algorithm is called Multi-Agent Deep Deterministic Policy Gradients. In a nutshell, the way it works is by using what's known as an actor-critic method. Each agent is an actor, and each actor has its own critic assigned to it. The critic's job is like a coach, to advise the actor on what actions it should reinforce to get the best reward. OpenAI's algorithm is novel in that each critic is enhanced, so it can access the actions and observations of all of the agents. This gives it better performance over another approach where critics are siloed. I cloned OpenAI's code and created my own version of a plus-shaped environment with the tools available to me. Initially, I tested this with two agents. Qualitatively, these agents are shown to exhibit the correct behavior. They seem to avoid each other and also reach their goals. In three agent scenarios, I found that agents were more or less able to reach their goals whilst avoiding each other. However, from time to time, agents did seem to clip each other as they moved past, and sometimes they even collided head on. And adding a fourth agent doesn't make problems better. Here you can see agents can sometimes make it to their goals, but at other times they seem a little confused. And sometimes they might even leave the obstacle course altogether, which essentially is cheating the game, which obviously is not allowed. And when a fifth agent is added, all agents seem to be paralyzed. They don't know what to do, they're not even sure where they are, and there doesn't really look like there's much hope of them reaching their goals at all. Removing the walls of the plus environment overcomes this problem. Agents can now be seen reaching their goals. Let's go back to the three agent scenario. The results we experienced were okay, but could they be better? Maybe there is an optimal balance of rewards and punishments that optimizes for the desired behavior. To investigate this, I conducted a two-dimensional parametric sweep. This means I simultaneously varied each agent's goal reward and crash punishment between 0 to 9 as inputs. I outputted the average number of collisions per agent per episode, as well as the average number of goals reached per agent per episode. My results displayed that whilst the goal reward didn't have much of an effect on output behavior, the crash punishment had a significant effect on both the number of collisions and number of goals reached. This suggests that the parameter that controls how sensitive agents are to collisions is the most important to fine-tune. The higher the crash punishment, the more defensive agents are. This allows them to avoid collisions, but at the cost of not reaching their goals. The lower the crash punishment, the more aggressive agents are. This means they reach their goals more frequently, but are not afraid to crash into each other in order to do so. My experiment demonstrates the inherent trade-off between defensiveness and aggressiveness in multi-agent navigation. So far, we've looked at self-play demos. This is when AI plays against AI. But what might happen if an AI plays against a human? I created a game where the objective is for the blue agent to collect as much food as possible. Food is shown as a small grey dot in this video. In this demonstration, the blue agent is policy trained using reinforcement learning. The red agent's objectives are to make it difficult for their blue adversary to reach the food. They do this by getting as close to the blue agent as possible to block its path. One thing to note is that the red agents have been trained in the presence of an AI adversary. They have never experienced a human adversary before. Would they necessarily behave the same way if a human's inputs were to replace the policy behind the blue agent? In this demonstration, the blue agent is human-controlled via keyboard inputs. Clearly, the human is not as efficient as the previous AI player. However, this change in behavior is hardly noticed at all by the red agents. It seems that they do not care how their adversary is controlled. They simply follow their own objectives. My results indicate that the introduction of unpredictable human behavior does not throw AI-trained agents off their policy. This suggests that if an autonomous vehicle were to encounter an unpredictable human driver on the road, it should continue to follow its learned policy as it had done in training. Automaker tech firm Mobileye, who was acquired by Intel in 2017, is interested in using multi-agent reinforcement learning to establish a driving policy for autonomous vehicles. It is critical that this field is well understood because of its impact on public safety. Thank you for watching my final video presentation, and special thanks to Tom Drummond and Akansal Koskan for supervising me throughout the year.